Hello children, welcome to part 2 of our story, The Gift of Magi. Yes, do you remember our young couple, Jim and Della? Yes, they were going through a rough patch of life, but yes, both of them were struggling to make each other happy. What do you remember? What was Magi going to do? She was looking at herself into the mirror and she was getting strange thoughts. What thought did she get and what did she do? Let's find out. She wanted to buy a gift for her partner and she had very little money. Yes, and she was very, very proud of her hair. On went her brown jacket. She wore her brown jacket. She was going somewhere. On went her old brown hat. She took her hat, she wore it, she wore her jacket and she rushed down. With a whirl of skirts and with a brilliant sparkle still in her eyes, she fluttered out of the door and down the stairs to the street. She ran down. She was thinking of something. She opened her eye. She had opened her hair and then she tied it up and then she cried. And now she's running on the streets. What is happening? Where she stopped, the sign read, Musafirone. Yes, that was a saloon. Hair goods of all kinds. What do you get here? You get wigs. You get artificial hair here. Why did she come here? One flight up, Della ran and collected herself. Panting. What is panting? When you run fast and you can't breathe and you stop to breathe. Yeah. Madame, large, too white, chilly. Hardly looked the Saffroni. Now, Saffroni is a pretty lady. What did this lady look like? She looked like old, white, chilly, and not interested. Will you buy my hair? Asked Della. Della asked her, will you buy my hair? I buy hair, said Madame. Take your hat off and let's have a sight at the look of it. Now she said, nowadays you don't even eat well. All your hairs are so bad. They don't look nice. And I don't buy bad hair. What did Della do? She opened her hat and as we all know, down rippled the brown cascade. You remember the waterfall? The brown waterfall? Like that her hair fell down. So beautiful. $20, said Madame, lifting the mask with a practiced hand. She removed her wallet and she removed $20 and gave it to her. She was so happy. Della was excited. Della was very happy. Give it to me quick. Give it to me quick, said Della. She took the money in hurry, didn't even say bye to the Madame and ran away. Oh, and the next 2 hours tripped by on rosy wings. What are rosy wings? It's like pretending you're sitting on some pink color rosy wings and you're very happy and flying. Forget the harsh metaphor. She was ransacking the stores for Jim's present. Now that she had money, she was happy and she knew she can buy anything. But what did she do for that? She gave up her precious hair. Yeah. She found it at last. It surely had been made for Jim and no one else. There was no other like it in any of the other stores and she had turned all of them inside out. She had gone to every store and market and every street. This is the only thing she found which was perfect for Jim. It was a platinum fob chain, simple and chaste in design. It was a chain for his watch, for his clock, properly proclaiming its value by substance alone and not by meretricious ornamentation. There are some jewelry which only look good but have no value. This had value, a lot of value, as all good things should do. It was even worthy of the watch. As soon as she saw it, she knew that it must be Jim's. Jim's will love this. It was like him. It was when she saw it, She could say that it's made for him. It's made for Jim. Quietness and value. The description applied to both. $21 they took from her for it, and she hurried home with the 87 cents which were remaining with her. With that chain on his watch, Jim might be properly anxious about the time in any company. Grand as the watch was, he sometimes looked at it on the sly on account of the old leather strap that he used in place of a chain. He was using an old leather strap in place of a chain. He was feeling a little bad. She knew about it. And so she knew that this chain is going to make him very happy. Yes. When Della reached home, her intoxication gave way a little to prudence and reason. She got out her curling iron. She was very excited about her new hair and lighted the gas and went into work, repairing the ravages made by generosity added to love. Now she had cut her hair and she was not used to short hair, right? She had to discover new hairstyles for that. So she switched on the gas and she went inside and was trying new hairstyles, which is always a tremendous task, dear friends, a mammoth task, a mammoth, a big, huge task. If you have something in the house to try that new thing, it's a huge task. Now, within 40 minutes, her head was covered with tiny clothesline curls that made her look wonderfully like a truant schoolboy. She didn't know what to do with her hair, so she managed to just make something and she looked like a schoolboy. She looked at her reflection in the mirror long, carefully and critically and confusingly, and she was thinking, am I looking nice or am I not looking nice? This was something new for her. If Jim doesn't kill me, she said to herself, before he takes a second look at me, he'll say I look like a Coney Island chorus girl. He says you look like some singer. Oh my God, what happened to you? And he's going to kill me. But what could I do? What could I do? Oh, what could I do with $1.87? That was too little for me to buy a gift for Jim. Yes, I needed money and I had to do whatever I can for that. At 7 o'clock, the coffee was made and the frying pan was on the back of the stove, hot and ready to cook the chops. Dinner was ready, coffee was ready, and now she was waiting for Jim to come back. Jim was never late. Della doubled the fob chain in her hand. She tied the chain in her hand. She was really conscious and sat on the corner of the table near the door that he always entered. So she wanted to see him as soon as he entered the door. Then she heard his footsteps on the stairway down on the first flight. And she turned white just for a moment. She got a little scared and worried. What will be Jim's reaction? She had a habit of saying little silent prayers about the simplest everyday things. She closed her eyes and she said a little prayer before Jim could enter. And now she whispered, yes, please God, make him think I am still pretty. Because she cut her hair, she was feeling a little bad and she wanted Jim to still think that she is pretty. The door opened and who entered? Yes, her beloved Jim entered and he closed it. He looked thin and very, very serious. Poor fellow, he was only 22 and to be burdened with a family. He was only 22 years old and he had a family to take care of. He needed a new overcoat and he was without the gloves. It was so cold. It was Christmas time. He did not have gloves. He did not have a coat. He was burdened by a lot of responsibilities. Jim stopped inside the door, as immovable as a setter at the scent of his quail. Jim moved and he was just looking at Della. He did not move. His eyes were fixed upon Della. and there was an expression in them that she could not read. And it terrified her. She was thinking, Jim, are you happy or are you angry or are you upset? You're just staring at me. What is the reaction? It was not anger, nor surprise, nor disapproval, nor horror, nor any of the sentiments that she had been prepared for. He simply stared at her fixedly with that peculiar expression on his face. She was thinking, what expression is this? She was confused. Della wriggled off the table and went for him. She moved from the table and she ran to him. Jim, darling, she cried. Now she was getting impatient. Don't look at me like that. I had my hair cut off and sold because I couldn't have lived through Christmas without giving you a present. I'll grow out again. They will grow out again. You won't mind, I know. Will you? I just had to do it. I could not even think of any other option, and I would feel bad if I didn't give present to you. My hair grows awfully fast. Don't worry, my hair grows fast. Say Merry Christmas, Jim, and let's be happy. You don't know what a beautiful, nice gift I have got for you. You don't know what I've got for you. Jim still doesn't know that. You can see how happy she is by giving him that. Here we come to the end of part 2. I still have a surprise for you. Yes, Jim also has got a gift for his beloved. What is the gift and what is his reaction after seeing Della? We will find out in part 3. Now let's solve some questions related to part 2. This is the end of part 2. I hope you understood the story till now. Now let's attempt some questions. Are you ready for the questions? Go on to question number 8 on page number 40. How much money did she get for her hair? Do you remember she went to the salon to cut the hair? How much money did she get? She got $20 for her hair. Yes. Now question 9. What did Della buy for Jim? What do you think she went to the salon for? To cut her hair. Why did she cut her hair? To buy something for Jim. And what did she buy? Della bought a platinum fob chain to be used for Jim's watch in place of the old leather strap that he used before. She did not like that leather strap he used, so she bought a beautiful platinum one. Question 10. How was the gift worthy of the watch? The platinum fob chain was simple and chaste in design, properly proclaiming its value by substance alone and not by material. Question 10. How was the gift worthy of the watch? The platinum fob chain was very simple and chaste in design, properly proclaiming its value by substance alone and not by meretricious ornamentation. That means the watch was not in value because it was an ornament. Its value was in the substance. That means the love for her that she bought the gift and Jim really wanted it. The writer says that the platinum chain was like Jim. A platinum chain like Jim. How? Della feels that the platinum chain was like Jim. Quietness and value, the description applied to both. Both were quiet and both were equally valuable. They would not speak of their ornamentation. Question 12. What did Della try to fix before Jim got home? Yes, Della tried to fix her chopped hair with curls before Jim got home because she was not used to her short hair and she did not know how Jim would react. Question number 13 on page 40 itself. What was Jim's reaction when he saw Della without her lovely hair? Jim was dumbstruck. He was shocked upon seeing Della. His eyes were fixed upon Della. And there was an expression in them that she could not read. Remember, she was confused about, is he angry or is it happy? Right, remember? Now, we will read the following extracts and answer the following. This is the extract. It is from your story only. She got out her curling irons and lighted the gas and went to work repairing the ravages made by generosity added to love. What does generosity refer to? Generosity referred to was the readiness of Della to sacrifice the most precious thing that she had, her shining brown hair. She was generous. She did not care about her hair. She wanted to get something for Jim. B. What repairing work was carried out? Her hair was being curled in order to make it look pleasant. Why was the girl repairing the ravages? Della knew that Jim would be shocked and disappointed to see her beautiful hair chopped off. Hence, she tried to repair the savages, repair the outcomings. She went and cut her hair. Now, how would Jim react? She was a little scared. Yes, we are done with the question answers too. But don't forget to play the... Yes, now we are done with the question answers of part 1. Don't forget to play the quiz and give some nice points. See you.